Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett, and today we're going to look at creating PowerShell modules so we can manage and maintain our own scripts. As always, you can find these videos on theurbanpenguin.com. If you're on Twitter, you can follow me at theurbanpenguin, and on Facebook, you'll be able to find and like my page as The Urban Penguin. So let's get straight into the demonstration. So we're going to begin by looking at PowerShell functions. PowerShell functions can condense a whole load of commands and variables that we might want to be used into a single lump of code that we can refer to by a single name. So the same as functions within, let's say, your Linux bash shell, or functions that you might be used to using even within other programming languages, be it scripting languages or compiled languages. So they're a very useful part of any environment. Without modules, we would have to really create the functions on the fly, which doesn't make a lot of point. We could have them in our profile, so we could put them into our login script to PowerShell, but then they're going to be loaded every time whether we need them or not. So generally you're going to find you've got 300, 400 lines of code that is loaded each time you start up your PowerShell, but most of the time you're not going to need that functionality. We could create a whole load of scripts and then run the scripts when required, but this is really the purpose of PowerShell modules. So first of all, let's just get the idea of a function correct. I can then go through and create a function in my PowerShell environment. So function, we can give the function a name. We might just say get hello, and then we can describe our function, and we could just go through and do something like that, and then write host and then hello world and then close that off. So that function is residing in memory, so I can then issue get hello. I've got tab completion on that, and then when we hit enter on it, of course, I get the hello world. Of course, we could provide more functionality. It's not just writing to the screen, believe it or not. And we can start taking input parameters. So we could have a function that collects a whole load of arguments that then can be used to pass values through to a compiled commandlet. So of course, in PowerShell, we can use snap-ins and modules to add in functionality. But with modules, we can have script modules that only contain scripts. Here we're looking at a module. We can see that its name, my.psm1. So all we've got to do is give it a name and an extension of .powershell module psm1. We can see that we've got a write host message that's shown the module is loading, and we're setting the foreground color. And then we've got our function get welcome message, and then we're just writing hello world. So very much in the same as our function outside of the PowerShell module, we can create then our module and build in the functions that we require. It doesn't just have to hold one function, it could contain many functions. To make use of this, I can import the module. If it's one of the standard directories, and we'll look at those directories in a few moments, I will be able to then just specify the module name. But ours is not in a standard directory, so we can then put the path through to the directory that contains the module or the module file itself. So I'm going to go through to see users, Andrew, documents, and then my PS1. So we see then the PowerShell module is loading. That was outside of the function, so we see its functionality irrespective of running any command. But then if I use then the get welcome message, we can then see I'm getting the hello message displayed on the screen. If we want to say, rather than hello world, let's say we want to accept an input argument, so we can say hello Andrew or hello Bob or whatever, I still accept it's not exactly the groundbreaking development you might be writing for your own environment, but it's building up until we get a little more scripting skills. We can then just go to our write host hello world and then put $args. If we want to change the color, then again we can have foreground color, and then we'll have, let's say, yellow this time. We can save the change and we'll just exit out from here. Of course, it's currently loaded. If I try to reload it, it's not going to work. But what I can do is put minus force on. So with minus force, if the module is already loaded, it is going to reload. If I want to actually see that's happening, if I put the minus verbose switch on, so let's just move across so we can see that. So we're importing the same module. The module is currently loaded, and we can see then that we're removing the imported module. Then we're loading the module. Once we read in the function, then we're exporting and importing the function. If I look now at my get welcome message, we can say welcome Andrew, and then we get hello world Andrew. So we get to see a little bit of what we can do. But I say I'm putting the full path through to this script, which isn't so normal. If we want to automate the process of modules a little bit more, especially with version 3 of PowerShell, where modules can auto-load once we enter their function names, we need to make sure that the functions and modules, rather, are stored correctly in the directory structure. So moving then through and picking up my modules, let's just copy this across. And put it into PowerShell. So I'm in my Documents folder and Windows PowerShell. Here's my PowerShell profile, the login script. But I'm going to create a new directory, modules. And then in this subdirectory, we're going to create then a module based on its name. So it's just called my, and then paste my module in there. So the module must exist in the modules directory in a subdirectory with the same name. So these are per user modules, there are also system modules. If I close out of this, if I take a look at the PowerShell module path, so if I use env and then ps module path, we can see that it's pointing then to my own folder, PowerShell modules. But we saw in the previous video, we're also looking in Windows System 32, Windows PowerShell version 1 modules. And we may have additional elements loaded, such as I've got the Citrix module. So we're pointing through to an additional directory. So with that in my module path, if I go through and get module, we can see I don't see any, but if I go through now and then list available, we can see that I can see my module being available to me. So now I can run the import module and my. So now my module is available to me, and when I finish with it, then I can remove module my, so it goes away. So of course we need to understand a little bit more about PowerShell scripting to put real functionality into these modules, but you can see how we can create our own blocks of code and create modules out of them, and then they're conveniently loaded as required. Thank you very much for watching this video, and I do look forward to seeing you back on the Urban Penguin channel very soon.